Hello, my name is Steve. I've been working for PRS for about 6 years now. I'm going to show you a few things today. Starting with the inlay bench. A lot of work and pride goes into it. Everything you see before you is made by PRS and sent to us. The most recent, the 25th. Kind of a newer bird, but with shadowing included. We use a variety of materials. First being mother of pearl. Also use green ripple. Green heart. Kind of has a pinkish hue to it. Kuo or Kawa. Traditional outline. That's the majority of what we do with Avalon. This is our slotting jig. This one's built for a 25-inch scale length. Customized depth. Basically the blade spin. All it takes probably about 10 seconds altogether. I'll level it out. Adjust it accordingly. Take it flush. Rounding jig. We use this for Santana scale lengths and a 12 string. More for an 11 and a half inch radius. Kind of old school, but it was how it was done back in the day. Basically, clamp it in. Chalk it up. You basically adjust the size accordingly. Take it down further as you need to take out more. Basically, you're aiming for an hourglass shape. Less in the middle, more at the ends. So when you get to the leveling bench, it's a lot easier to go about. But now we've got technological. Come on, kids. Faster. Basically, the job of a leveler is to make sure that obviously the neck is completely level. being flat. And clean up the front door. As you can see, it's basically a rough cut right now. Still have all the CNC cutter marks. It's my job to get rid of that. Make it look as best as possible. Start off with 80 grit. Just get a general 10-inch radius on it. Over it. We'll glue it up again. Make sure there's no pitting. Once the glue is dry, knock it off. Constantly checking the level. Gotta make sure it's flat all the time. And the radius, most important. Make sure the radius is perfect. Because down the line it counts a lot more. When they're putting in frets, when they're fret leveling in fact, the closer it is, the more specifically it is, the easier it is to intonate and play, actually. We go through great lengths to make sure it's a perfect 10-inch radius. Lastly, we'll do 220. At this point, 10-inch radius is a given, for the most part, we check it anyway. You check for any flaws, mineral stains, pits around the inlays, anything that would be up below par anyway.